Mm-hmm. Like, I work with Mexican males. They're getting to skin oils. But it comes up with a wrong resistance. That means that it's just a rope on it. As it's free wheeling, no brakes or plug. It came up with around about 1,100 kilonewtons of pressure. So that's quite all right, as long as it doesn't go over 1,500. Took a fair while for it to stop the brakes, but they are actually working. It came up with 11,000 kilonewtons per side. So that's wrong, truly working okay. And it is actually illegal. The guy tells me he's got the front brakes wound off. I can't, mate. Just because it actually does meet requirements in an unladen state like this, doesn't mean to say that it is actually okay, because as he said, if he's got the brakes wound off, well then you've got actually too much travel brake fluid. Excess brake travel can be defected. Right, we're now getting to move forward onto the shaker plates. We're right, he's going to give him a shake right on that. He's actually going to tackle it. Take a little bit out of the front end. He's doing there by lifting the rear front wheels up off the ground. We're checking to make sure there's only kingpins and thrust rushes. There's no excess thrust up and down. The rule of thumb is that if you can put a 5-cent piece in there, then it's nothing like your economics. Let's go, Adrian. Can you get a 50-cent piece in there? What Adrian's done is he's actually checked the kingpins. He's checked the thrust. He's also checked the actual anchor around the springs. Make sure the U-bolts are tight. And now he's just checking the steering. And then turn up on that. Now we'll try the back end. We're going to make it.